Hello, Piyusha ma'am. Welcome to Their Masterpieces. How are you doing today?
I'm doing fine, thank you. How are you doing?
I'm great, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us today. So, ma'am, can you walk us through your career journey?
Yes, sure. So, I did my MBA in Human Resource Management from Mumbai University.
Okay.
Till now, I have about 16 years of work experience, predominantly education and skill development industry.
Okay.
So, I have been mainly working on the field like HR, administration and employment generation role, which is popularly known as career management or, you know, campus placement kind of role, wherein on the one hand, I have been interacting with the companies to find out their needs and requirements with regards to freshers, understand what they are exactly looking for in terms of skills and abilities. And what is the training that they want to give. On the other hand, I have been interacting with the students. Mm-hmm. I have been talking to them, making them realize, you know, what is required during the interview, how they can speak, how they can behave. So, likeway, in my profile, I have been interacting with the students right from the school ones to undergraduates, to postgraduates, to the ones who are pursuing vocational studies and also those who are pursuing skill development programs. Mm-hmm. In fact, in my recent assignment, I have been dealing with the NSDC, which is National Skill Development Corporation, to set up a skill development center, which is a CSR initiative by one of the leading beverages company in India, wherein I have been interacting with NSDC and Sector Skill Council to set up the skill development center and to run the center. So I have So basically, I have been fortunate enough to interact with all the stakeholders in the education industry, be it government, it institutes, be it students, and obviously the parents.
Okay.
So that's been the journey so far.
Okay. So, ma'am, you basically have a lot of experience with kids, dealing with kids. So, at what point in life you decided to join Dheya as a mentor?
To be very honest, I have been pursuing Dheya since its inception. Wow. So, maybe in the year 2005 or 2006, I got to know about Dheya through some mentors that I had received. I always believed in the philosophy of mentoring. It is very much required, something like shadowing. So I was pursuing here and I just wanted to understand what do they do. Mm-hmm. And gradually, for a period of time, my experience also built up and I was seeing here anyway. So at one, especially this year, when the national education policy came up, I finally decided to get this field full-fledgedly and associate with here as a mentor. So that is how I'm here now. Talking about, you know, mentoring and the guiding
processes. Okay. So, ma'am, how do you think Dheya is changing the perspective towards, you know, mentoring or counseling?
Yeah, sure. So, when we talk about mentoring, career guidance, you know, career planning, all this concept, parents till now or even the students are still in a dilemma whether they want to opt for, they are looking for future course of action in terms of courses, or they really want to find out whether what is matching with their strengths and abilities.
Right.
So, what I find different about AI in particular is that we, as a part of mentoring community, we do backward integration. So, we go to the roots and the basics and we find out what are the strengths of the students and then try to align it with the career that are there available anyway. The difference, major difference that I find with Dheya vis-a-vis the other people. So, yeah, I mean, that's really kind of interested me and I would really want to tell others, you know, to look for such options rather than just looking for careers which are anyway available. So you don't have to go to somebody to, you know, them to tell you what are the career options. They are there.
What
is the match between two?
Right. So, Dheya is changing perspective towards mentoring and counseling. So, how do you think they are very different, they are working very different from others?
I found out this difference when I was evaluating the options of Dheya vis-a-vis doing, you know, aligning myself with other companies. So, I would happily like to quote that the other companies that are there in the market, they are mainly there to propose the courses. So, for example, there is a student in a 10th or 12th or whichever standard he is in, graduate, postgraduate, if they go to a career counselor, the career counselor will tell them, okay, now you're here. So now these are the options that are available to you. So for example, if you have done your 10th, now you can go for diploma or you can go for 12th. After 12, you can do this. Or if there is, if you're interested in fashion designing, go for this. You know, that kind of counseling is available. What they add is, as I said, we do backward integration. We go to the basics. We find out whatever the kid is planning to do or whatever the parents want them to do, is it really aligning with the kid's interest?
Right.
So that's exactly where they are differentiates from the other people in the market. And that is why I really like and appreciate being a part of their community.
Thank you so much for being part of Deya. I just want to ask a last question. There is so much competition in this education world and parents are pushing their kids but not knowing what the kid wants. So what message you want to convey to those parents?
See, from the experience that I have got being an educationist for over 15 years now, having been interacted with so many parents along with their kids, without their kids, and now having been mentored people through scientific tools, what I have observed is there are two categories of parents. There are few who are like sitting back and thinking, okay, my kid knows everything. These kids are like very advanced. They have already decided what they want to do in life. They are little relaxed. Good thing in a way. But my advice would be always validate and verify their career options. It is always good on the part of the parent to know what their child is exactly going through. Secondly, however good your kid might be, it is always good to have a backup option.
It
is good not just for the kid, for you also.
Right.
At no point in time in their career, they or you should feel, you know, aisa kiya hota to acha rehta tha.
Right.
So have a backup option. There is another category of parents who are like, let's see what we have to do. Let him clear his 10th. Let him do his 12th. Will then go to career counselor if required. Will then speak to somebody. To those kind of parents, my humble advice is always good to start early. So your child may be in 10th or even 9th or 8th, they are matured enough to think about various options.
Right.
This generation of students have a lot of access to various resources.
Right.
They know who is doing what. It's just that maybe they are a little bit lazy, that they are not, they have not figured out their options. So please don't sit back till the child completes his 10th or 12th. Please, if there are trustworthy resources that are available, please make use of those resources. The two things that I definitely want to suggest to the parents in particular.
Thank you so much for the advice and thank you so much for your time. And thank you so much for being part of Deya. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Pleasure is mine. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.